was the tail side plate assembly. Okay, so now we need bag. What bag? Three. Here's bag three. Y'all don't understand. I can't wait until I do my first big helicopter build. That's gonna be awesome. The smell of new parts is amazing. I love that smell. Okay. Alright. Getting distracted here. Hey, look at that. We can use that bag to store those. Yep, you're gonna end up with a bunch of these. I'm tired, guys. But, oh, look at that little bitty cute bell. Little bitty tail. Oh, so cute. Alright, you got one of one, or three of one, three of two, three of three, and three of four. So there's four bags in this one, apparently. How'd you sneak by? Oh man, I forgot. I got to make sure this memory card don't get full fast. Okay. I hope you guys enjoy this. I know I enjoy watching build videos of other guys. I hope it helps too, because there's a lot of videos that have helped me, you know, that I've watched whenever I've got a helicopter used, and it's like, okay, how do I take this part off? I ain't got no manual or nothing like that. I can get on YouTube and bam, there it is. Everybody shows me. So I hope this does help somebody, and yeah. Y'all guys want to help or anything like that, just let me know.
It's...
Eat it.
I got all three of us.
Well, that's Sissy. She wants one. I don't want that now, but thank you. See, look at that. He made us a sandwich. Ain't he sweet? You still need a shirt on. Okay. Back to this. No, he made me a sandwich. He's so sweet. He's a good boy when he wants to be. Alright, tail assembly. We're going to be using the old blue Loctite. Alright, now we need bag one. That thing is so little. Lay down, Ellie.
This is what I put on it.
Okay. Just eat it, okay? These parts are getting smaller and smaller, y'all. Okay. Now, apparently, we gotta take this piece and stick it to the outside of here. Stabs the right way up. Oh, they do give you an Allen wrench too, by the way, guys. So, they literally give you everything you need. Remember, a little drop goes a long way. What? the tail slide piece is already pre-assembled with the bearing, because it's saying use the green Loctite for the bearing itself. Just leave mine in the kitchen, okay?
Okay. When you want it, it will be in the kitchen.
Yes, I will let you know. Thank you.
Okay.
There's the first part of the slide. Now. The bell crank level assemblies. Go eat in the room with your sister or whatever.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And remember, guys, there are some small, tiny pieces in this thing. Okay? I mean, I ain't even gonna attempt to show you them washers. Wow, they're little. Alright, now we will do the easiest part, which would be the bigger uni ball. Okay. That goes in to the end. No surprise they don't say use Loctite on that thing, but it's plastic, so I guess yeah, that is plastic. I don't know if I like that or not. Might have to look for an upgraded one. See if maybe they have a metal one. Well, maybe the old one was. I'll go ahead and put all these uni balls in. Oh no, that's a tail pin. Okay. That's not a uni ball, that's a tail pin. Oh, I got you. So, that right there is actually what locks the. Ooh, man, that's scary. Little piece of rolled. This is what locks the tail in place to the slide. That is right. Okay. Now see, this one is not assembled, but see those little things? Alright. But apparently, you need to flange bearing. You need to get one of them in already. And I would recommend putting the one right there in first, because you have to put the shim in there along with a washer on the bottom and a washer on the top. Which, man, that looks. Alright. It might be easier to do it. See, I don't want to put all it together because that is going to flop around inside there. It's not super tight. And that's going to be hard to line up. So, we're going to do this a little differently here. Alright. We will have to skip ahead a little bit. So, we'll come back to that. But I got an idea. What I'm going to do is the bolt. The bolt apparently is a little right there. It's the bolt. Okay. I want that bolt to. Well, here, we can go ahead and do that now. I want to put the bolt in there, so this way it'll line everything up before I go to cap that off. Because once you cap it off, you kind of can't go back in there. I mean, you can, but I mean, why the headache when you go ahead and do it this way? Alright. see. Okay. Start with that side. Alright. This right here should work out pretty easy for you. If you start with that side, leave this open. Thomas, leave her alone. Take your bolt. What? Now, there's no washer, apparently. Okay. Anyways, see how I got that? Now, what I can do is take these little bitty washers right here. I mean, they're super small, y'all. I'll go ahead and put that right there. And that's on. And then take the little spacer or the bushing. And then you throw the other washer on for the other side. And now you can take the other end piece of the flange bearing. Put that on the shaft. And of course, whenever you tighten everything down, now it's all assembled. And you don't have to sit there and shake it around to push the piece in there and then have to fight it. Now, I'm getting old, guys. For some reason, this is extremely relaxing, y'all. I really enjoy this. I really, really enjoy this. Enjoy it too much, maybe. Okay, so this facing this way, the stop. Kids are arguing, but you see how that's flat side in there, right there is rounded. That goes towards, that goes away from your tail. Okay. Okay, so that goes there. Alright, and you're gonna need your belt as well. Okay, let's see if we can get all this going here. I do love the way brand new parts smell, y'all. That is such a little belt. Look at that little thing. It's so pretty. Do not crimp. Okay, we will not crimp it. Okay. So there's there. Okay, you gotta get your belt on. You know, sometimes I wish I had like 5 hands. That would be awesome. Now, you gotta get your main shaft. Thank you. See? I messed up. Okay. Yeah, and as long as you catch your mistakes beforehand, you won't mess up too bad. But apparently this thing goes in a little differently than I thought. I looked at the picture and I just seen that thing sticking out like that, so we're gonna fix that problem because something didn't look right and I was like, what in the world? But hang on, I'll show you what I did. Shouldn't have to apply Loctite again. It should be enough, but see a difference? Yeah. It happens. Okay. Now we have that. Actually, might be able to do this a little better. Apparently there's two sets of holes here. You want to go to the one that's going to line everything up for you. Put a little too much. That's okay. Yeah, enough for both. So it's gonna be the bottom set of holes. You don't tighten nothing down, you should be alright. See how I got that? Now, remember the round side goes towards your tail itself, and then the little flat sided piece goes towards your blades. And then again, like with the other one, it's got a little notch. But you don't need your belt just yet. You can get all this together, apparently. But the other notch that was in there on the shaft itself, that's where this other set screw goes. Apparently it's going to be a smaller Allen bit as well. Sorry y'all, I was trying to make sure the camera's still recording. See, they give you a set. Now that thing is flimsy, but apparently I got one small enough there. There we go. flop out of there. You want some green Loctite on this one. Because hopefully if you got to do repairs or something like that, you don't have to take this piece back apart. That screws down inside of there. Remember, they said stuff's going to be a little tight. It's actually pretty smooth. Let's see. Tighten this one down. What that allows is for that thing to pivot right there. It is a little tight. That's all right, though. Other than that, our tail assembly is done. And of course, the belt goes around there. Just like that. But that's the tail assembly. Ooh, now we get to put it on the tail. Which, of course, we are going to use the new one. Not this junk. These pieces are usually glued into the tail. We're gonna add a little to it to keep them in place. You don't need a whole lot. putting some in there to kind of get them to stay in place, because it did come off a little bit. So what that glue is going to do is keep them in place. And keep it all lined up so now, whoever had this before me, they actually put Velcro on the tail, so that way the canopy also has that on top of the magnets that are there. Which is a pretty smart idea, especially if you're sitting there flying hardcore 3D with this little thing. Yeah, it's liable to fly off. It's getting there, guys. It's getting there, y'all. Okay. Hopefully. Yes, we're going to use new bolts. Everything, all the hardware is going to be new, y'all. Just remember, y'all, when you do put it in there, guys, be gentle, because if you're not, you can actually knock that the mounting brackets out, and you don't want that. Hold on, I'll show you what I'm talking about. Usually they're glued in pretty good from factory. You see them in there? Yeah. That's what I was putting the glue on. Now we will get all our washers under our bolts. Kind of makes life easy. Just about need a set of tweezers to be able to pick up some of these pieces. And then says to use the blue. Dot. actually. Now, of course, you want your letters up and you want your tail over there on the right side there. Tell you what, how you guys like the wind? It has been crazy